हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड हाइड्रोलिक मशीन्स। हियर वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग अवर टॉपिक ऑफ डायनेमिक्स ऑफ फ्लूइड फ्लो, एंड इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट नोच एंड वियर। सो लेट्स क्विकली रिवाइज दिस पार्ट। सो फर्स्ट इज नोच। It is a device used for measurement of flow through a small channel or tank. And second is a wear, that is, it is a concrete or masonry construction placed in an open channel over which the flow occurs. Now, one topic that I have given you in self-study, that is classification of nooch and wear, and I hope that you have completed this by yourself. Now the next topic is discharge over rectangular nooch or wear. So here we have taken a small strip, and we have already derived this part, and now we will move forward with our next topic, that is discharge over triangular nooch. So what we are going to do here is we are only going to take the figure from here, and we will derive the whole equation in this lecture. So let's begin here. We will start with the nomenclature. H is equal to head of water above V nooch. And theta is equal to angle of nooch . So now here what we are going to do is we will consider a horizontal strip like this having a thickness of dh. So let's first have a small discussion on this figure, that this is a triangular nooch that we are having. The total height of the water in this nooch is capital H. The angle of nooch is theta. Here is the we have taken a small strip, that is AB. This strip is having a thickness of dh, and this strip is situated at height h from the free surface. And this considered as a mean line, and we have taken this triangle OCA, that is theta by 2. Now let's begin our analysis. So we will first focus on this triangle. So we will apply 10 here. Let's say it has 10 theta upon 2 is equal to CA divided by CA CO. So here it is equal to CA upon capital H minus small h. So this is tan theta by 2 . So the value of CA is equal to theta by 2. So this is the value of CA. So if you see, CA is the half portion of this strip. So the width of the strip is equal to AB. So its value will be equal to 2AC is equal to into h minus h into 10 width of strip. So here this is the width of the strip. So now the area of the strip that we will be calculating which is equal to width into thickness. So it will be 2 times to BH. So here this is the area of strip, and now the next is we will calculate theoretical velocity is equal to square root of 2gh. Now now the discharge through this small strip that we will be calculating is BQ is equal to CD into area, that is 2 into H minus H into 10 theta upon 2 into dH into velocity, that is gh. Now we will calculate q is equal to square root of integration of dq. So it will be from 0 to h. So here we will take constant terms outside and rearrange this equation. So now is equal to CB into 10 theta by 2 square root of 2g into integration 0 to h into capital H minus small h square root of h into dh. So here it will be 2 cd 10 theta by 2 h into h raised to 3. So let's integrate this. That is equal to 2CD into 10 theta upon 2 square root of 2G into h raised to 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2, and we will have integration over 0 to h. So here is equal to two C D tan theta by two square root of 2 G Are we missing anything here? I think we don't miss anything. Yes, you can continue. Is equal to 2 CD by 15 h raised to 5 by 2. So finally what we will be getting here is 8 by 15 CD tan theta by 2 square root of 2g h raised to 5 by 2. So that is the value of q. Now CD, let's say that we are discussing about now right angle notch. For right angle so here theta will be equal to 90 degree and let us assume CD to be equal to 0.6. So when you put these values over here, then the value of Q you will be getting is 1.417. That's a ratio 5/2. So this is the end of this derivation that you can also do this now. Now let's move forward with our next theory. So discharge over trapezoidal notch. So here we have taken a case of trapezoidal notch in which the total height is capital H. The angle subtended here is theta by 2 and the length is L. So here to obtain the value of Q, we are considering two different things. First is this rectangle ABCD, and this we are combining these two triangles. That is, here it should be a combination of F A B plus B E C. So this is the combination that we are having. So we can have a discharge through a rectangular notch and a discharge through a triangular notch. So combination of these two. So here let's say CD1 is equal to coefficient of discharge for rectangular portion A B C D and CD2 is equal to coefficient of discharge or triangular portion. That is F A B plus B C. So Q1, that is through rectangular portion, it will be 2/3 of CD1 L into square root of 2G 2 H raised to 3/2 and Q2 is equal to 8/15 CD2 into 10 θ/2 square root of 2g 2 h raised to 5/2. So Q is equal to finally Q1 plus Q2. See, one thing I need to mention here that these two equations we have already derived in our previous theories. So we have simply a combination of these two here. So this is the end of today's theory, and we are also ending this lecture over here, and this is also end of this chapter. So we have already done this in our slides. So if we quickly revise this portion, as it was a very long chapter, so let's have a small revision of our topics. So we begin with equations of motion. Here we obtained a Reynolds equation of motion, Navier-Stokes equation and Euler's equation. Then we derived Euler's equation of motion like this, that is del P over rho plus G dz plus V dv. And based on Euler's equation, we obtain Bernoulli's equation, that is for ideal fluid, and this is the Bernoulli's equation for real fluid. Then the practical applications of Bernoulli's equation, three applications are there: Venturi meter, orifice meter and pitot tube. So first we discussed about Venturi meter, we obtained the value of Q. Then we discussed about orifice meter and we obtained the Q. The last was pitot tube. The momentum equation, then force exerted by a flowing fluid on a bent pipe, and then flow through orifice, hydraulic coefficients, determination of CD, CV and CC, flow through large orifice, discharge through fully submerged orifice, discharge through partially submerged orifice. Then we discussed about nose and bear. So here we discussed the rectangular nose, then triangular nose, and last one is the trapezoidal nose. So this is the end of this chapter, and let's have a look on the syllabus now. So here we have completed fluid and their properties, static forces and buoyancy, motion of fluid particles and stream, and finally we have completed the energy equation and its applications. Now next we are going to skip chapter number 5, 6 and 7, and we will directly move forward with the impact of jet and hydraulic turbines. And hopefully what we are going to do is we will first complete 9, 10 and 11, and then we will complete 5, 6 and 7. So in this way we are going to complete the syllabus of this subject. So this is the end of this chapter and end of this lecture also. Thank you for watching this video.